Mechanical textiles 2. We will be continuing with the unit 3, that is the mechanical protection. In today's lecture, we are moving on to a new topic in the mechanical protection, that is the ballistic protection. So from the word, you can understand ballistic means something related to projectile or flights, where there are some bullets which is fired. So ballistic threats mainly refer to the bullets fired from the handguns or rifles and fragments from an ordinary shell or bomb explosions. So in order to protect from these ballistic threats, the body armor or the ballistic or type of an armor has long been used to protect the soldiers on the battlefield. So when you see the historical perspective, from the time immemorial, we are using various types of materials, from the use of a leather in the east to the chain mail in the west. People never stopped seeking the better personal protection. If you see this diagram, these are the choice of materials over the years. From the 3000 BC, people used to protect themselves for using the wood or linen or animal hide also. For example, if you see in the Greece or Western Europe, people started using the leather armor during 3000 BC itself. And with the progress in time, the use of material gets changed. You can see people have used steel armor also. And during 1000 AD, Egyptians have used materials like linothorax. Linothorax is a material which is made up of a linen to protect from the ballistic threats. And after the industrial revolution, with the inventions that came, people started to use materials like nylon. Nylon was the first material to be used in the ballistic type of clothing after the industrial revolution. And these silk was also being used as a material to confer the ballistic protection. And with the improvement in the time and the inventions, the use of high performance fibers, yarns, ceramics and composites came into being. So people started to use many type of fibers like Kevlar, PBO, Nomex, many kind of fibers, high performance fibers were used, and ceramics were also used, and composite materials were also used for the body armors. Now, what is a bulletproof vest? We will see. Bulletproof vest is a protective clothing that can be made from different materials that absorb the impact of projectiles fired from weapons and explosive fragments fired at the body. It can be prepared from steel or titanium, ceramics, polyethylene and Kevlar. So what are the types of body armor? Body armors are mainly classified into two types. One is the hard body armor and another is the soft body armor. What is hard body armor? Hard body armor is mainly made up of metal or ceramic plates that are inserted into the fabric structure. So it is used in protection from high caliber rifles. So it is often used in the high risk environments. It is not used in the normal type of an environment. So it is used in the high risk environment. There are some disadvantages associated using the hard body armor. Though it gives a good protection from the bullets, but the material is very rigid and heavy, less flexible and heavier than its soft counterpart, which is the soft body armor. And also it is more uncomfortable, hotter and more difficult to use for long period of time. And coming down to soft body armor, this mainly consists of layers of fabric made up of high performance fibers, like we have seen Kevlar or Kevlar, Nomex or other type of fibers. Many high performance fibers are there, like Xylon, those kind of fibers, PBO, PBI, there are many fibers are there. Those kind of layers are made up of, used in the soft body armor. These are mainly used in the low velocity impacts. So in this hard body armor is mainly for the high velocity impact, but this is for the low velocity impacts. It is mainly made up of multi-layer woven or laminated structures. And it is relatively more flexible, used for routine wear by police officers, enforcement officers, who are likely to face lower level of ballistic threat. For them, this soft body armor is recommended type of a material. But the disadvantages with the soft body armor is, in order to give the ballistic protection, if we cannot use one or two layers, we have to use multiple layers of woven or laminated structures. So in that case, if more fabric layers are arranged together, it will actually create discomfort in wearing. It will increase the weight also. So you can see this is the diagram of a typical hard body armor. It is heavy and it is made up of steel or ceramic, and it has a long shelf life, and it has a stress fracture resistance also. But when you see the soft body armor, it is made up of material like a Kevlar Twarone, which is a Kevlar material, and it has a less shelf life, like only for 5 years, and it is pistol threat protection. It does not give a high risk protection, only for normal handguns like a pistol type of a weapon can this soft body armor can protect from the small threat by using a pistols. So what are the materials for body armor design? It is expected to meet a number of requirements. So it should be strong enough to provide the wearers with sufficient ballistic protection. It is required to have a lightweight and low bulk, aiming not to influence the wearer's mobility and efficiency. The person who is wearing the armor should feel that the weight of the garment is less, and he should be able to move very freely and efficiently. And the material should also be durable, making sure that the performance of armor does not affect under the adverse condition, because the soldier who is wearing the body armor, he will be exposed to a high temperature during summers and less temperatures during the winters. So any kind of a moisture or a UV kind of a light should not affect the body armor. And the material have to be flexible also, and in order to give comfort. This is also one of the important requirement. Now, coming down to the general principles of ballistic protection, an important thing to note is your ballistic vest do not deflect the bullets. Instead, it catches the bullet and spreads its force over a large portion of the body. So what are the two important mechanisms here which we need to see? Is one is the absorbing the energy, and another is the dissipating the energy. These two you should remember. So a material, a bullet vest, should absorb the material from the deforming bullet, bring it to a stop before it can completely penetrate the textile matrix. And once it is absorbed, it should also dissipate the energy. It should absorb the energy and it should dissipate the energy of the fragment or shrapnel, whichever is the type of a bullet that is impacted on the textile material. That strain energy should be dissipated. The projectile strain energy should be dissipated throughout the textile material, so that any kind of a stretching or breaking of yarns in the main layers of the high performance woven fabrics in the ballistic vest. So this is important. It should absorb the energy from the deforming bullet, and it should dissipate the energy of the bullet by stretching and breaking the yarns in the main layers of the high performance fibers, high performance woven fabric in the ballistic vest. Now, when the response of a soft materials to ballistic impact we are going to see. When a textile material, that is the soft body armor, when it is impacted on a yarn target or a fabric target, how the mechanism works, that we are going to see. For example, when a yarn is impacted, so that what will happen, two wave fronts are generated, namely a transverse wave and a longitudinal wave. What is the use of these two waves? Energy is dissipated through the propagation of two types of wave. As we have seen, when the bullet strikes the body armor at a very high speed, once it is the yarn target is impacted, it produces two types of waves. So that through these two types of waves, the energy gets dissipated. So one is the longitudinal wave, another is the transverse wave. In the longitudinal wave, it travels along the outward, along the fiber axis, at the sound velocity of the material from the point of impact. So once the longitudinal wave is generated, it also causes the yarn to be stretched and have a in-plane movement. You can see this diagram here. This is the longitudinal wavefront from where the yarn gets stretched out. This is how the longitudinal wavefront takes place when the projectile is impacted. So this is the in-plane movement, where the yarn gets stretched and it has a in-plane movement. So the longitudinal wave travels at a velocity called c, So it is given by an equation C equal to E by root of E by rho, where C is the longitudinal wave speed, that is the longitudinal wave speed which is expressed in meters per second. This longitudinal wave speed should be very high. And E is the fiber modulus in Pascal, and rho is the yarn bulk density in grams per meter cube, which is the normal density, fiber density. So for example, in order to have a very high longitudinal wave speed, so what we should do, the fiber modulus should be higher. If the numerator value of the fiber modulus, that is the capital E, when it is higher, and this rho, the density, if it is lower, so what will happen, the longitudinal wave velocity will be, wave speed will be very high. So that if the wave speed becomes very higher, it will easily dissipate the energy throughout the textile material or on the body armor, so that the person who is wearing it, he will not undergo any kind of a injury very easily. So that is the understanding. But however, on the contrary, if you see the when the fiber modulus becomes lower and the bulk density becomes higher, in that case what will happen, the longitudinal wave velocity will decrease, so that which is not good for us. So that will lead to only reduction in the longitudinal wave speed. That is not recommended. So two things happen. One is the longitudinal wave velocity, and another is the projectile tend to push the yarn forward. One is the, we have seen that yarn stretching and the in-plane movement, and another is the, it will, the projectile tend to push the yarn forward and deflect the yarn vertically, which results in the out of a plane motion of the material. This is what we have seen. When it hits like this, one is the longitudinal wavefront formation and another is the transverse wavefront formation. In longitudinal wavefront formation, which is the in-plane movement, and the yarn gets stretched. But whereas here, when the projectile strikes through, it forms a out of plane motion where it deflects the yarn vertically. So these two wavefronts are very important in dissipating the energy. So now we will discuss the mechanism of the ballistic impact on a fabric target. When a projectile strikes the fabric target, the response is a combination of a global response and another is the local response. What is this global response? This indicates the behavior of the material away from the impact point. Normally, the global response occurs at a low impact velocity. For example, if the speed of the bullet that is striking the body armor, if it is low, so that what will happen, the global response occurs. So if the speed is less at the low impact velocity, what will happen, the projectile kinetic energy will be transferred to the fabric target, so larger areas get involved in the energy absorption, that is the larger areas of the textile material that gets involved in the energy absorption than at the high impact velocity. If the impact velocity is very high, in that case larger area will not get involved. But whereas when the impact velocity is lower, the larger areas get involved in the energy absorption. So the two waves, that is the longitudinal and the transverse wave, sweep across the fabric and transfer the projectile energy into the fabric strain energy and the kinetic energy. These are the two important mechanisms. So at a low velocity dynamic impact, there are various mechanisms that occurs. How the energy absorption occurs, energy can be absorbed through mechanisms like yarn pull out. If the yarn come out, yarn gets pulled out because of the less friction between the warp and weft yarns. For example, it is in the, let us say it is in a woven fabric. If the yarn gets pulled out, then it is a low velocity impact, it happens. So through that mechanism also the energy can be absorbed. Or another is the yarn can get extended, that is one of the mechanism. And or through the yarn rupture also this energy absorption can occur. So this is the schematic diagram. For example, here this is the global response, where when the projectile strikes here, it actually gets somewhat like a tent formation, like it gets some little extension. You can see a curve is shown here, which is a low velocity impact. But whereas here, this is the high velocity impact, which is the local response, which we are going to see. So what is a local response? Local response occurs at a high impact velocity. So when the velocity is very high, in that case, what will happen? the projectile engaging time with the fabric target becomes short. So there is no chance for a global response. The chance for a local response becomes higher. So here the fabric failure mode, whatever occurs, like here, which we have I showed you earlier, like some sort of a tent type of a design deformation occurs here when the projectile strikes through the armor. So when it strikes through, there are the body armor can get failure by through many failure fabric failure modes that are like yarn or fabric can be ruptured, and other modes like fibrillation or melt damage can occur. For example, when it comes to fibrillation, normally when you use a Kevlar type of a fiber, the fiber has a pleated structure, and when your garment is made up of body armor is made up of multiple layers, because of that, when it is impacted by the high speed projectile, the energy absorption can take place by fibrillation. So fibrillation is one of the energy absorption mechanism, and another is the melt damage. For example, when we use a material like a ultra high molecular weight polyethylene, which is one of the material used fibers used for the ballistic protection, that when the high speed projectile gets impacted, because of the production of high heat, the material will first get melted. So that is also one of the energy absorption mechanism. And another mechanism is, for example, depending upon the shape of the projectile, the impact will be different. For example, if a projectile or the bullet shape is in the form of a flat shape, then it will actually cause more fabric or more fiber or yarn rupture. But if the shape of the projectile is in the form of a hemisphere, then a hemisphere or in the form of a ogival shape, then for that it may not have that kind of a rupture. It may actually cause some extension also. So there are various energy absorption mechanisms are there, like we have seen in the yarn pullout, in the when we discussed in the local response, where the friction when it is very less, that it causes the yarn pullout. So there are multiple mechanisms are there, and all these mechanisms are not constant. It will vary depending upon the type of the impact and the velocity of the impact. So now we have come to the end of the discussion on this ballistic protection. So in today's lecture, we have discussed about the introduction to the ballistic protection and the mechanisms that are used and the types of body armors. So we will continue further in the next lecture on fibers and the fabrics that are used, depending upon the fiber or the fabric, how the ballistic protection becomes more effective. That we will discuss in the next lecture. Thanks for listening. Have a nice day.